today, Caritas Antilles, through its youth volunteers from the Youth Emergency Action Committees, or known as YEAC, will be having a second deployment to assist the hurricane-affected persons in St. Vincent and the Grenadines. So the group of 8 volunteers will be taking relief supplies, namely solar lanterns and hygiene kits, women care kits and disaster hygiene kits, to the islands of Kanuan, Mairo, Union Island, and some persons on the mainland. This is the second time we're deploying a team. The first team was deployed on July 13th, and they also went with tarpaulins. We are working very closely with the Diocese of Kingstown to really continue assessments and to be able to bring relief on behalf of the Roman Catholic Church to the affected persons in those respective countries. We are also working very closely with the St. Vincent National Emergency Management Organization and the Ministry of National Mobilization to be able to bring assistance. This is just the first step in really helping our brothers and sisters who have been affected there, and we plan to assist with the early recovery process through our expertise. The youth are trained in first aid, CPR, leadership and life skills, shelter management, warehousing, and all various aspects of emergency response. So they're very excited to be able to assist persons who have been affected and to bring some relief and to let them know that they are loved and they are not forgotten by the Roman Catholic Church through its social action agency of Caritas Antilles.
YEAC stands for the Youth Emergency Action Committees, and we're a project of Caritas Antilles.
Today we're gearing up for our third response so far to the countries affected by Hurricane Beryl. That includes Grenada and St. Vincent. This time, as a project of Caritas Antilles, we're taking 7 volunteers along with ourselves to the island of St. Vincent and the Grenadines, as well as the islands of Bekwe, Kanawan, and Union Island, to help those who were affected by the storm.
In addition, we are responding to our brothers and sisters in Grenada, in Petite Martinique, in Carriacou. We have shipped 400 water filters to help those persons with who don't have potable water, access to potable water, and disaster blankets, 200. We have also had pre-positioned items, which Caritas Grenada was able to use, namely tarpaulins with their fittings, hygiene kits, women care kits. We've been able to provide that to Grenada. We have also launched an emergency appeal with the Caritas Confederation, which is to have a two-pronged approach to helping Grenada in its early recovery process. We'll be looking at psychosocial support in collaboration with the Franciscan Institute for the persons who have been traumatized by Hurricane Beryl, and also multipurpose cash assistance with shelter non-food items, or NFIs, to persons who will need support in helping repair their homes to be able to have somewhere safe to stay. So we are also supporting Jamaica through our partner St. Patrick Rangers, and we have also distributed a number of hygiene kits, tarpaulins, food items, and in Jamaica they are collaborating with NADMA, Food for the Poor. We have also been supported in all of these pre-positioned items with Food for the Poor, our partners, Food for the Poor Inc. from Miami, and also Catholic Relief Services, which is a sister Caritas organization, Caritas USA, CRS Empower. So we have pre-positioned items. We were able to respond almost immediately to our brothers and sisters, and we are thankful for that sort of support and the level of training that our young people have had to be able to respond in such a prompt manner.